Good afternoon, and welcome to American University of Antigua's 2020 Virtual Commencement Ceremony. We are glad you can join us today and hope you are all staying safe.
Good afternoon, and welcome to the American University of Antigua's 2020 Commencement Ceremony. My name is Vernon Solomon, and I'm the Vice President for Administration. I join you today from our campus on the beautiful island of Antigua. In my capacity as the director of the Emergency Medicine Training Center and Clinical Simulation, I'm almost certain that I would have had the distinct pleasure of working with many of you that are in our virtual audience today. It warms my heart and the hearts of the entire AUA family to be with you on this very special day. We cannot help but feel a sense of pride seeing each and every one of you here today. Today is truly a testament to you, to your hard work and commitment. Having worked along with our students from their very first moments on the island, even meeting many of them as they landed at VC Byrd International Airport, down to the last basic science exam, I truly appreciate and understand how important the support of their families would have been throughout this entire journey. That being the case, parents, family members, loved ones, give yourselves a round of applause, because today, June 12th, 2020, is your day too. Before we begin, there are a few points that I would like to make, particularly as it relates to COVID-19. Due to the global impact the virus has had, AUA regrettably had to make the difficult decision to cancel the live 2020 commencement ceremony for May 29th, 2020 at NJPAC. Protecting the health of our graduates, their families, alumni, faculty, and staff of AUA is our highest priority in the face of this unprecedented coronavirus pandemic. There was no way we could possibly plan to bring over 1,000 people to NJPAC for our commencement ceremony in May. It would not have been responsible on our part. Nonetheless, we began working on alternate plans to allow our 2020 graduates a chance to celebrate their commencement. Deliberation brought us to where we are right now, the AUA 2020 virtual commencement. Commencement is one of the most time-honored traditions in our society, and it is one of the most highly anticipated celebrations at AUA for students, their families and friends, and we are honored to provide this venue, this virtual platform in which to celebrate your achievement. Please note that this session is being recorded. Information will be provided at a later date as to how you may be able to obtain a copy. Graduates, family members, friends, you are asked to please stand, if you're able, for the singing of the Antigua and Barbuda National Anthem. To follow will be the National Anthem of the United States. Performing the Antigua and Barbuda National Anthem will be AUA staff member Karen Ash. Performing the United States National Anthem will be AUA staff member Melissa Morrell.
So proudly we hailed at the twilight's last gleaming, whose broad stripes and bright stars through the perilous fight, o'er the ramparts we watched, were so gallantly streaming, and the rockets' red glare, the bombs bursting in air, gave proof through the night that our flag was still there. Oh, say does that star-spangled banner yet wave o'er the lands of the free and the home of the brave?
Thank you very much, ladies. Our first speaker is President of American University of Antigua, Mr. Neil S. Simon. Mr. Simon's career encompasses many years in medical education administration. He is the former president of Ross University College of Medicine and School of Veterinary Medicine. He has been a professor of medical jurisprudence to medical students and residents. Mr. Simon and the founding group of physicians and medical education professionals created AUA with a mission: to provide a superior medical education to students committed to the highest standard of learning. Mr. Simon and the entire AUA family are committed to graduating skilled, ethical, and caring physicians, and are dedicated to breaking down the barriers that have prevented underrepresented minorities from obtaining a medical education in the United States and subsequent licensure. Without Neil's vision and determination, many of our advancements could never have been realized. Our graduates are a testament to that commitment and dedication. Ask you now to please turn your attention to Mr. Neil Simon.
I want to begin by congratulating the graduating class of 2020 on obtaining your MD degree. I know it has been a long, hard road you have traveled in order to become physicians. I also know that the last few months have emphasized how important physicians are to our society and the health of our society. You have become part of a profession that has always been held in high esteem. And the COVID-19 pandemic has evidenced the bravery of the profession you are now entering. At first, I thought it was kind of sad that after all you have accomplished, that we would not have a live commencement ceremony where you could hug your fellow graduates and family members and celebrate in person with your fellow students, faculty, and deans. But as I thought about it, there really are some advantages to a virtual commencement ceremony. For example, female graduates might want to appear fashionable in uncomfortable high heels, but now they can attend this ceremony in socks or even barefoot, while not compromising their reputation for fashion sense. On the other hand, male graduates who wish to wear high heels can attend this ceremony without feeling the least bit awkward. And for those of you who are late risers, you can even attend this ceremony while lying in bed. In fact, the best of all, you do not have to even pretend you are listening to me. Your pictures do that for you. So you can turn down the volume, listen to music, or talk on the phone as your pictures make you look like you are hanging on to every word I say. Before I conclude, I want to give you one word of advice. Listen carefully to the speakers who follow me. They are physicians, and I can promise you that they all have something important to say. So in closing, let me just say thank you and congratulations.
AUA's University Provost, Dr. Robert Mellon, is our next speaker. Dr. Mellon graduated from the University of South Carolina School of Medicine in 1981 and finished a residency in family medicine at the same institution in 1984. He was a tenured professor at the Medical University of South Carolina and a staff physician at hospitals throughout South Carolina. He is the recipient of the Teacher of the Year Trident MUSC Family Medicine Residency Award, Golden Oyster Teaching Award, MUSC Trident Family Medicine Residency Program, Navy Achievement Medal for Life-Saving Medical Services Rendered to an Injured Sailor, and numerous Teacher of the Month awards. Prior to becoming AUA Provost, Dr. Mellon served as AUA Executive Dean of Basic Sciences from 2014 to 2018. We now welcome Dr. Robert Mellon.
Hello, doctors. Yes, I'm talking to you. I'm not likely to be the first person to call you doctor, but the difference is today I'm right. As of today, you are doctors of medicine, physicians. You have worked very hard for this day, I know that. I watched you. You are not healthcare providers, not hospital staff, not employees, not health workers. You are doctors, physicians. You deserve the respect that goes with that title. But wait, in addition to that respect comes awesome responsibility. Many of you have seen that responsibility in action over the past few months. Be grateful for that. You now know something really important. Are you prepared to put your patient's welfare above all else? Are you willing to put your own health and life at risk to take care of your patient? This is not some idea now. It's part of your experience. If you did not have to make that decision yourself, you probably saw it made by your residents and your attendings. This is the price for accepting that title of doctor. This is your duty. When I was a fourth-year medical student and later an intern, I had the opportunity to learn this lesson. We began to see the emergence of a vicious disease that was taking the lives of young gay men all around us. This was the beginning of the HIV epidemic. Initially, we had no idea what was causing it. We did not have the technology to identify the virus as quickly as we do today. We were seeing otherwise healthy men die from diseases that we were used to seeing only in patients being treated for cancer. Diseases like Kaposi sarcoma, pneumocystis pneumonia. Their immune systems stopped working. We suspected that it was infectious, but no one knew at the time how it was transmitted. People were scared, afraid they would catch it and die. Some, not many, but some physicians that I knew and respected refused to care for these patients. They were afraid they would catch the disease and die. While I saw some refuse to enter those rooms, I saw many more willingly care for these patients without the knowledge that the disease was not so easily transmitted. I too willingly went in those rooms, but it was not a testimony of my courage or dedication. It was the norm. It was expected. It was my duty. I was a doctor, and this is what doctors do. This has been true throughout history, during the plagues of Europe, during the Middle Ages, during the influenza pandemic of 1918, doctors did their duty, cared for their patients, despite the risk to themselves. There were exceptions, but these were indeed exceptions. What is this thing we call duty? It is defined as moral or legal responsibility. This idea that the patient's welfare supersedes our own is not new. It is as old as our profession. None of us do it perfectly. In my experience, however, to the extent that we do our duty, to that exact extent do we reap the rewards of our profession. So thank you for your willingness to accept this responsibility. Thank you for caring for your patients, no matter what, in any situation. Thank you for doing your duty. Welcome to the profession, doctors. I'm proud to call you colleagues.
Thank you very much, Dr. Mellon. The following speaker is AUA's Vice President for Global Education and Executive Dean for Clinical Sciences, Dr. Peter Bell. Dr. Bell has served as Assistant Medical Director of the Department of Anesthesiology and Intensive Care Medicine at Aussie-Klinik Damp in Germany, and has completed numerous national and international rescue missions as an emergency physician of the German Air Rescue. He served as medical director of the Caribbean Helicopter Air Ambulance Service and Maritime Medicine Consultant. He chaired the Department of Anesthesiology and Intensive Care Medicine at Halberton Hospital in Antigua prior to joining AUA in 2005. We eagerly await your words, Dr. Peter Bell.
Dear graduates, faculty, friends, and family, it was the best of times. It was the worst of times. It was the age of wisdom. It was the age of foolishness. It was the epoch of belief. It was the epoch of incredulity. It was the season of light. It was the season of darkness. It was the spring of hope. It was the winter of despair. Charles Dickens wrote 1859 in his Tale of Two Cities. I believe this quote refers well to the unusual times we are facing at present, where all of our lives have been impacted by the COVID-19 pandemic. Participating in a virtual commencement ceremony is, I believe, a first for all of us and indicates that not only times, but our lives have changed and will continue to do so. The world is facing new challenges, not only due to the effects of the pandemic on individual and population health, its social and economic impact, but also the way how countries, peoples, and individuals react will determine the future of mankind. As physicians, our role is significant, not only in providing patient care, but also in shaping the future of our society beyond our profession. In times when tension between individual health versus population health versus economy, science versus belief systems become evident, the expertise of our profession is vital for finding solutions for our society. While some of you have already been on the front lines of patient care during the pandemic, in clinical rotations, all of you will face new and different challenges during your transition into residency. In addition, you will also be working as physicians in a social and medical environment which is facing and has to overcome enormous challenges. It is indeed the best of times for you to make an impact on individual patient care and society at large. I wish you all the best for your personal and professional future and congratulate you and your families on achieving your goal, becoming a medical doctor. Thank you.
Thank you very much for that, Dr. Bell. Our keynote speaker is indeed an AUA favorite, the College of Medicine's very own provost, Dr. Seymour Schwartz. Dr. Schwartz served as the chair of the University of Rochester School of Medicine, Department of Surgery. He has received an appointment as Distinguished Alumni Professor from the University of Rochester School of Medicine. Dr. Schwartz has published extensively. However, he is likely best known for his textbook, Principles of Surgery, which is considered by many to be the definitive textbook on the practice of surgery and is used in almost every United States medical school. In addition, Dr. Schwartz has authored nearly a dozen other textbooks that are used in medical schools across the United States. He has published more than 50 individual chapters of various textbooks, over 200 articles, and continues to lecture extensively at medical schools throughout the United States and the world. We now welcome Dr. Seymour Schwartz, our keynote speaker.
Graduates of the class of 2020, I am pleased to address you on this most significant occasion, the commencement of your lives as physicians. Although the ceremony that has been referred to as a graduation ceremony or a commencement ceremony is in your case of necessity, quote, virtual, the fact that the adjective virtual has been added in no way detracts from the event. In defense of my insistence that this virtual ceremony is an equivalent ceremony, let me invoke etymology, that is, the study of the origin of words and their usage. The word virtual actually first appeared in the 14th century, meaning something of excellence in almost every respect. With it firmly established that a compromise of ceremony in no way compromises the certification of the fact that you've completed the requirement and are totally capable, let us move on to consider the unique aspects of your class, the class of 2020. 2020, as we all know, defines normal vision, but more panoramically, general acuity. So yours is the only class that can lay claim to an association with numerals indicating you're being acutely perceptive. Yours is also what is called a decadal year, that is a year ending in zero. And this, you and I have a common graduation year. I graduated in 1950, exactly 70 years prior to you. As far as my own experiences concerning graduation, I never attended a graduation. Neither my undergraduate graduation from the University of Wisconsin or my medical school graduation, and there were peculiar reasons for that. At the time of our graduations, 70 years apart, each of us have witnessed the powers of the force of nature. In your case, a new virus making an assault on all of mankind. That new virus takes its name from the fact that on electron microscopic examination, each virion, V-I-R-I-O-N, that is the name given to the infective form of the virus while it is outside a host cell. Each virion is surrounded by a corona or a halo. And really is ironic that the most minuscule, the smallest of pathogens, characterized by a slight but distinctive glow, is responsible for aborting your ceremony, which is generally characterized by a distinctive glow, both emanating from the graduate, and their family pride. On the 70th anniversary of my graduation, I can still recall the havoc and apprehension that the polio epidemic created. Polio epidemics began to occur in the early 20th century, peaked in the 1940s. And when I arrived as a surgical intern in Rochester in June of 1950, one whole patient unit was still occupied by patients sustained by cylindrical iron lungs, breathing for them. And a practical vaccine to prevent polio was not available until 1954. Now, as you prepare to embark on your medical careers, I need not emphasize that you will be witness to and perhaps participate in the latest battle between pathogens on one side and physicians and scientists on the other. To put the present in perspective, let's take a brief historic tour. Beginning with the variola or smallpox, a disease that was the scourge with which the early settlers of our colonies contended and the early citizens of our young nation had to contend. It was a disease that existed from ancient times, but during the 18th century, that disease killed an estimated 400,000 Europeans annually. The attempts of prevention were initially by inoculation. That was the deliberate introduction of material from the pustules, the small pustules of infected individuals, into the skin of uninfected individuals to prevent or decrease the severity of disease. But inoculation was not without danger. Jonathan Edwards died after inoculation in 1758, shortly after assuming his position as the third president of Princeton. It was then called the College of New Jersey. On the other hand, General George Washington ordered mass inoculation of the Continental Army in 1777, and he was the first military leader to do so, and it's felt by some that it contributed to the ultimate victory of the Continental Army. And then in 1796, Edward Jenner, an English country physician, substituted material from the pustules of cows infected with cowpox to minimize the adverse effects of the human inoculum. Thus the word vaccination, vacca coming from the Latin for cow, vacca. In 1967, the World Health Organization intensified a worldwide effort to eliminate smallpox. It was led by Dr. Donald Henderson, a graduate of the University of Rochester and a student of mine. The global eradication of smallpox was certified in 1979. And immunization subsequently proved successful in the case of a broad variety of childhood diseases, also tetanus and rabies. And yes, in the case of my own encounter, poliomyelitis has now been almost totally eliminated. So what can we anticipate regarding your upcoming encounter with the coronavirus? Based on the accomplishments that medicine have made during my 50 years as an active participant and the subsequent two decades in which I was mainly a member of the audience, my odds, and as they have always been, are on the physicians and scientists over and above the pathogens. It was a group of subsequent graduates to me that during my 70 years in medicine, one, introduced effective antibiotics to treat and cure a variety of infectious diseases. Two, added chemotherapy and immunotherapy to achieve success against malignancy. And perhaps one of the most poignant examples is acute lymphoblastic leukemia in children. During my medical school days, leukemia in children was associated with a 90% early mortality. Currently, remission occurs within weeks of beginning treatment, and cure is complete in over 90% of cases. Another advance in my realm of surgery, we've been repairing major arteries endoscopically. We've been removing intrathoracic and intra-abdominal tumors by minimally invasive techniques and consequently shortening the postoperative hospital stay and the distress associated with surgery. We have transplanted the kidneys, the pancreas, the liver, the intestine, the heart and lungs, all with anticipated success. And we've also operated and corrected congenital complex cardiac lesions during infancy on patients who were less than 10 pounds. So as you embark on your individual paths as professional participants, you must remain dedicated students, because what were facts during your schooling may become falsehoods in the future. But what remains unchangeable in the practice of medicine is high moral standards, which is the very Webster definition of the word virtue. Virtue is equivalent to high moral standards. And virtue is the very noun from which the adjective virtual attached to your commencement ceremony came.
Thank you very much for that, Dr. Schwartz. We always appreciate your words of wisdom. At this time, I would like you to direct your attention to the following special slideshow presentation of our graduating class.
Closing time, open all the doors and let you out into the world. Closing time, turn all of the lights on over every boy and every girl. Closing time, one last call for alcohol, so finish your whiskey or beer. Closing time, you don't have to go home, but you can't stay here. I know who I want to take me home. I know who I want to take me home. I know who I want to take me home. Take me home. Sisters come. So gather up your jackets, move it to the exits. I hope you have found a friend. Closing time, every new beginning comes from some other beginning's end. Yeah, I know who I want to take me home. To take me home. I know who I want to take me home. Take me home. Some other beginnings end.
Wonderful job, guys, in putting that slideshow presentation together. Thank you very much. And now I'm pleased to introduce this year's valedictorian, Jonathan McHale. Jonathan McHale was born in Ontario, Canada. He was raised in rural Nova Scotia for a few years before returning to live in Toronto, where he attended high school. With the aspiration to become a family physician like his father and sister, he set his sights on Antigua immediately after high school to complete his bachelor's degree and enter medical school where his sister, Myrna, preceded him. He completed his bachelor's of human health sciences at ICASA, graduating as valedictorian of his pre-med class before going on to start medical school the following August. During his time at AUA, he served as a TA and tutor with the Educational Enhancement Department, volunteered with the Health Fair Committee, and was awarded the Dean's Award Scholarship in 2016. He graduated from AUA in December 2019 and will be starting his residency in family medicine at the University of Alabama in June. Please welcome Jonathan McHale, AUA's Class of 2020 valedictorian.
Last year, during the National AAFP Conference, I remember sitting in a conference room listening to a speech by a program director of a residency in Arizona. The program director was a doctor who had graduated from Ross, and the first thing she said was, "I am a proud graduate of Ross University." To my fellow classmates, now doctors, who have successfully overcome the challenges of the last 4 years, I think I speak for most of us when I say we have not had things spoon-fed to us. We have not had an easy time. But what makes this class in particular exceptional is our resilience. For most of us, we dropped our entire lives to move to a faraway country to pursue medicine. From day one, we found ourselves immersed in a different culture with the odds stacked against us. The expectations placed on us were way higher than for most medical students. With every corner we turned, there were new challenges thrown in our faces. But we were resilient. We formed a tight-knit community amongst ourselves, where we always knew we could trust one another. Everyone pitched in to help where they could with advice and resources. Every sleepless night, every poor exam result, and every time the rules changed to make our lives just a little bit harder, we took it in stride and overcame it. Every time we botched a procedure, we grinned through it and tried again. Every time we failed to meet our own standards of excellence, we dusted ourselves off and pushed ourselves until we got it right. That determination to succeed is the brand that each of us will carry on our foreheads as we go down our respective paths. And it is just one of the reasons that I can sit here today and say from the bottom of my heart that I am a proud graduate of AUA. I want to say thank you to the families and friends of each of the doctors present here today. All of the patients that any of us will ever have in the future will be indebted to you, to my own father and mother. I wish I had at least an hour to delve into how much I owe you and the amount of sacrifices you have made for my sake. But I will say, I am where I am because of you, and I am the person that I am because of you. Myrna, I'll always remember the guidance you gave me and the time that you flew out to Antigua to help me. Jeremy, I still remember the hours that you spent helping me to study for step one, even though you were 14 and you had no idea what you were reading to me. I wanted to say thank you to the professors and the doctors who slaved away to train us. Thank you for dealing with our silly questions. Thank you for being patient with us back when we couldn't tell the difference between a hand and a foot. In particular, I want to thank Professor Gathers from the EED. I want to thank Dr. Marcos for every time that you've helped me. I'm sure every graduate here has specific professors that they would like to thank. So let me also take a step back and thank all of the faculty and staff at AUA. I can honestly say I would not be standing here as a newly minted physician if AUA had not seen something in me and given me the chance to pursue my goals. And I know I speak for many others with that sentiment. As a Canadian citizen, I want to thank the people of the USA and Antigua. You've welcomed me, appreciated me, and trained me. I am honored to be able to continue my training in the greatest nation in the world that has given me this opportunity. I will do what I can to return the favor to the people of this country that have given me so much. And finally, and most importantly, I want to thank the one person that was my greatest source of support and strength, the person to whom I look to for guidance every day, the person whom on the days I felt like I couldn't keep going anymore was my only reason for persevering, the person to whom I owe everything, the great physician, my Lord, my Savior, and my God. Thank you, Jesus, because you've been faithful to me even when I wasn't. So, congratulations, class of 2020, and best of luck in residency.
Excellent job, Dr. McHale. Thank you so much. At this time, I would like to introduce our alumni speaker, Dr. Swaman Singh. Dr. Singh graduated from American University of Antigua College of Medicine back in 2015, then completed an internal medicine residency at Drexel University College of Medicine and Heinemann Hospital in Philadelphia, Pennsylvania. He is now a cardiology fellow at Newark Beth Israel Medical Center, Robert Wood Johnson Barnabas Health in Newark, New Jersey, and he has been selected to be an interventional cardiology fellow at Newark Beth Israel Medical Center. It is such a joy to see and hear from our previous graduates. We welcome you, Dr. Singh.
Congratulations to all my fellow doctors, and I welcome you to our team. I'm sure all of you have fought a lot of battles to be where you are today. It takes a lot of resilience and perseverance to get an MD after your name. I want to thank everyone who was involved in your journey to become a doctor. Please take this time to cherish your achievements with your family and friends. As they say, true character is revealed best during times of adversity. Looking back, I can say that the 4 years of medical school that I spent at AUA were both the most enjoyable and the toughest years of my life. This time taught me some valuable lessons on building friendships and teamwork, and my time at AUA gave me a chance to once again dream. Trust me, that's a big deal, because there was a time in my life when even dreams were hard to come by. Being an immigrant to the United States, I faced the same struggles as you and your families. My childhood interactions with diseases, poverty, and crime begged the change in not only my own life, but the lives of others around me. But at the time, due to the circumstances, getting through my own day-to-day life was challenging enough. Our family moved more than 10 times over the course of our first few years in America, all in hope for better schools and a safer neighborhood. But all those struggles feel like they took place in very distant past now, because in the end, someone trusted me. And I trusted them. That someone was AUA. This notion of genuine trust between me and my medical school opened the doors to endless opportunities. It would not be far-fetched for me to say that AUA handed me the keys to my car. Now, how far and how fast I go is on me. It's been about 5 years since I graduated from AUA. Since then, I've successfully started an NGO, Five Rivers Heart Association, with the sole purpose of enhancing education and healthcare in America and abroad. With our team, which includes many graduates of AUA, we've been able to provide free medication, books, and other items to thousands of people in grave need. I was recently even asked to host a TV show with the hopes of reaching an audience of South Asian patients and educating them about conditions that are as large scale as diabetes and hypertension. Over the past few years, I've had the honor of being invited to prominent cardiology conferences and being around some of the country's most renowned and respected doctors. I bring this up because it's a constant reminder of where I came from and where I strive to go. Surprisingly to many today, I dream to work in the same neighborhoods that once chased me away. You see, we must find ways to help others who might be walking the same path as us someday. We must end disparities in healthcare and education. As a doctor, you have a unique opportunity to write your own story, to give your life meaning beyond what you were born into. But you may never actually find your meaning unless you're willing to take on new challenges and accept every opportunity that comes your way. I urge you to explore the world during your time as a physician, because every human interaction offers a new world of endless learning. I encourage you to work as a team, align yourself with like-minded people or organizations, because no individual effort, no matter how great they are, holds any merit in the world of global healthcare. So join a team, or better yet, start to build your own. One more thing, doctors. Please remember that residency is about building your future. your future must have time for four important things, which includes your personal life, relationships, work life, and social contributions. So open your doors to the world. See you around, doctors. Congratulations.
Thank you so much for that, Swami. We ask you to now direct your attention to the special video presentation of our graduating class.
I just want to say thank you to my husband, my parents, my family, my close friends, and AUA. Congratulations, class of 2020. We did it.
AUA class of 2020, congratulations. We made it.
I want to thank my parents and my siblings for always pushing me to be the best that I can be, and the rest of my family, girlfriend, and friends for always being there for me. Congratulations, everyone.
AUA class of 2020. We did it. We survived medical school. We made it through years of studying, hundreds of hours in the hospitals. We made it through countless sleepless nights, and we made it through many, many tests. And of course, this may not be the graduation that we may have imagined, but nothing can take away from the fact that we are doctors. We did it.
Class of 2020, we made it. Congratulations to everybody, and thank you, AUA, for everything that you've done for us. Thank you.
I just want to say congratulations to the class of 2020. We did it. And most importantly, I want to say thank you to my family. I wouldn't have done it without you guys being there 100% of the way. I love you guys. We did it, Mama!
Hi, this is Dr. Akko here. I'd like to thank my family and thank AUA for making my dreams of becoming a doctor come true.
Thank you, AUA, for helping my dream become a reality. Class of 2020, I'm so excited to start residency.
We made it, family. Love you all. Next stop, residency.
Congratulations, class of 2020. Wish we could be together today for this memorable event. I wish you all the best in your future careers. Congratulations again, we did it.
First of all, I'd like to thank God for being the strength within my life. I'd also like to thank my family and my friends for being my support and guidance throughout medical school.
Hello everyone, my name is Dr. Garibola, and I'd just like to say congratulations to the class of 2020. I would specifically like to thank my family, friends, and the AUA faculty for allowing me to get to this point. I know each of us will be going into different specialties, and each specialty will have its own challenge. But I know that AUA has done a great job in preparing us, and that we will be able to get through these challenges. Thank you and congratulations again.
Yay, we made it, class of 2020.
And another outstanding and beautiful presentation, guys. We were privileged to hear from Mr. Simon earlier. However, I would like to invite Mr. Simon forward again to begin what you all have been waiting for, the degree conferral.
Graduates of the 2020 class, please stand. Virtually. Ladies and gentlemen, I present to you the class of 2020. Who have satisfied all of the requirements for the degree Doctor of Medicine according to the curriculum and guidelines of the American University of Antigua. Class of 2020, upon recommendation of the faculty of the School of Medicine and the Provost, and by the virtue of the power and authority vested in me, I attest that you have earned all the rights, privileges, and powers of graduates from the American University of Antigua College of Medicine. You may now move your tassels from the right to the left.
And now, without any further delay, we invite you to please pay close attention to your monitors as we introduce the graduating class of 2020. Thank you. I would like you to now follow along with Dr. Seymour Schwartz, who will be administering the Hippocratic Oath.
Graduates, it has been a long-standing tradition for doctors, particularly new graduates entering this noble and revered profession, to recite the Hippocratic Oath as a pledge to uphold and honor the high moral responsibility and dedication to the profession. As such, we will ask the new graduates to recite with us the Hippocratic Oath, which is currently being shown on the screen. Any physician in attendance who may wish to recite the oath with the graduates may do so as well. We do solemnly swear, each by whatever we hold most sacred, that we will be loyal to the profession of medicine and just and generous to its members, that we will lead lives and practice our art in uprightness and honor, that into whatsoever house we shall enter, it shall be for the good of the sick to the utmost of our power, our holding ourselves far aloof from wrong and corruption, from the tempting of others to vice, that we will exercise our art solely to the cure of our patient, and we will give no drug, perform no operation for a criminal purpose, even if solicited, far less suggested, that whatsoever we shall see or hear of the lives of men or women, which is not fitting to be spoken, we will keep inviolably secret. These things do we swear. Let us bow our heads in sign of acquiescence. And now, if we will be true to this, our oath, may prosperity and good repute be ever ours. The opposite, if we shall prove ourselves forsworn.
Congratulations, graduates. There are many paths you could have chosen in life, but you chose a truly noble path. One that allows others to entrust you with their lives, one in which you have devoted your life to the care and healing of others. And for that, each and every one of you is to be commended. Congratulations, class of 2020. So now please, turn to your family and your friends who are most likely there with you. Soak in this moment. 2020 will likely be a year that none of us forgets. For the wonderful events such as you now being able to call yourself doctor, but also for the horrors of a global pandemic. Despite it all, I ask you, focus on this moment. For it was in this moment, regardless of where you are in the world right now, that you were able to call yourself doctor. I would like to thank everyone for attending this momentous event. This concludes our virtual commencement ceremony. However, before we go, our faculty would not let you leave without them saying their final virtual goodbyes and best wishes to this class of 2020. Please continue to be safe, take care of yourselves, each other, and be mindful of those less fortunate.
Congratulations, AUA graduates.
Congratulations. Your hard work has earned you this success. Enjoy every moment of it.
Congratulations to the AUA class of 2020. All the best.
Congrats to AUA class of 2020. I'm so proud of you guys.
Hello, class of 2020 doctors.
huge, huge congratulations to you. Now get out there and kick some COVID butt.
Congratulations to the AUA class of 2020.
Congratulations to the AUA class of 2020.
Hi, my name is Dr. Adekunle Omole, Anatomy Department. I'm using this opportunity to say congratulations to the AUA 2020 graduate. Wishing you guys all the best. Bye.
Congratulations to the AUA class of 2020.
A big congratulations and all the very best to all our AUA 2020 graduates.
Congratulations to the AUA class of 2020.
Congratulations to the AUA class of 2020.
Congratulations, graduates. I'm Dr. Sonia Ford, Director of the University Counseling Center, and I bring you warm wishes as you begin this new journey. Remember to always reflect on the small joys in life.
Congratulations, AUA class of 2020.
Congratulations, doctors. I'm sure this isn't the graduation you thought you would get, but the world needs doctors more now than ever, so go out there, make us proud.
This is Dr. Rice. Congratulations to the class of 2020, and best wishes to you all.
Thank you for joining us, and congratulations to all of our AUA 2020 graduates.